Rajasthan. I think I need to put on record an excellent initiative by Governor Rajasthan, especially the Department of Labor and Skill and Elets. Because I think this topic is a demand of time. If you hear to the Honorable Prime Minister or the Honorable Chief Minister, we all are worried about employability and skill enhancement, so that we are basically able to enhance the employability of the youth. And it is very much relevant to our country, especially when we are the youngest country in the world. And I think, I remember I was there as a part of Joint Working Group Committee Chairman to Japan, and I could find that everybody is so crazy for Indians, looking to the youth population. But then basically there are a number of issues and challenges which we have been hearing since morning, that there is a gap between skill in terms of demand versus supply. And especially this is not because of only the system which has come in picture as on date, it is because of the education system also. Now, we are all well aware that society is basically facing major three challenges. One is the environmental, which is basically because of depletion of, you can say, natural resources, then global warming, like this. The second challenge which we have been facing is because of economics. That means basically there is a globalization going on throughout the world. There is a change in technology. Technology is changing very rapidly. And there are financial interdependence among the countries that is going on. And third and the most important, which we have been hearing for the last 4 or 5 days on TV also, that is the social. Why it is so? Because there is a growing global population. There is a inadequate in living standards, gaps, casteism, religion like that. And I think this all can be handled once we are educated. That's the reason the role of education comes into picture, and that's the way the quality of the education comes into picture. Now why I'm saying so? Because I think before we hear to the experts on the panel, there is a food for thought for everybody, for the panel as well as of the dais also. That now what is happening is the way things are changing, the way processes are changing. The World Economic Forum, because see the children who will take the admission, who is, will take the admission to school in 2018, and by the time 2030, when he will pass out from the college education, he doesn't know what will be the technology, the way it is changing. He doesn't know what will be the business prospects, because the way prospects are changing, the job things are changing. He will not understand what are the skills. At least since when I was born, I was aware that I have to become an engineer, doctor or an IAS officer and I will get a job. But the way things are changing, now nobody can predict or say that what will be the future for a youth in the country in 2030. That's the reason the World Economic Forum has come out with 10 skill sets. I think we have been listening about the skill sets since beginning, since morning. But these 10 skill sets are very important. And I think all need to know, especially those who are running the skilling center, those who are from the sector skills, I think sector skills must be doing well, because I as a DG have been interacting with them in Delhi also. And one of them is complex problem solving. That's the critical skilling which we need. Aaj ki tarikh mein bachche ko koi kaam dete hain, wo ghabra jata hai, sharma jata hai. Aur hota hai ki sir mein dard hone lagta hai, pet mein dard hone lagta hai. That's the mindset in the education system. So now we have to make him adaptable, we have to make him sensible to handle the complex problem solving. Now similarly, critical thinking. हम out of box thinking करते नहीं हैं. हम जो किताब में लिखा है पांच गाय के बारे में लिखी है, जो किताब निबंध में लिखा हुआ है, गाय दुधारू होती है, गाय दूध देती है, गाय हमारी माता होती है, वही पांच चीज लिख के आते हैं. हम कभी critical thinking करके छोटी चीज लिखते नहीं हैं. And once we start doing this thing, I think I'm sure we can lead to entrepreneurship. That's what basically is. Entrepreneurship and people management. How to manage the that is again a big issue. Jitne aajkal issues aa rahe hain market mein, whether it is a political or anything, they all are because of how to manage the HR, how to manage the team. Then decision making. Hum koi problem samne aati hai, when you are in the industry, once you grow slowly, you find decision making is a very important issue, where you have to take a decision on the spot, at the spot, and by your own experience. But we are very short of taking decisions. हम लिखा हम करते हैं ये हमारी एक मानसिकता होती है इसलिए सरकार में तो submitted for directions please. और मैंने वादे DG दिया रहा है to write that for what I need direction. तो They are not looking for a director. She is asking me for directions. He is supposed to give me idea and then I have to take a decision based on inputs. And similarly, creativity. That is a demand of the time, which will happen in the times to come. Then emotional intelligence, because now we have to handle situations sometimes emotionally. That is again a skill set which is required by the industry. Then flexibility. You cannot be so rigid that I am a hardware engineer, I will repair the computer. Sometimes you have to do marketing also, sometimes you have to face your boss also, sometimes you have to handle your customer also. And similarly, negotiation. And the last, the most important, which is being expected from every citizen, is the basically social orientation. We need to understand and respect each caste, creed, and basically working, that we have to work on. Now, see, there is a fundamental system of triple helix, where the three agencies play a major role. One of them is government. Of course, they are the policy makers, they are the executors who implement the rules. Then industry, which is basically employing the youth. And third is the education. Because education plays an important role to make us acceptable to the industry. So that is what basically is to be looked into. Now, why everything is happening, why we have been talking about quality and education, I think we need to understand one more concept, that is, what is quality education? You see, there are many countries who are leading education quality in terms of the best deliverables, that is USA, UK, Australia, Germany, like that. Why we can't compete them? Whereas we are well known for our brain, we are most adaptable. If you say that you have to travel in first AC, you will travel in first AC. And if you say that you have to travel in three tires or Malgadi, you will travel in emergency. You will do it. But after that, we are not able to deliver the best education. It means something is wrong in the education system. And since we have been hearing the morning, since morning, I do agree that now the concept of soft skills and basic skilling is required to be introduced in the education system since from 4th, 5th class. अभी क्या है हम मगब कराते हैं बच्चों को हम रटा देते हैं बच्चों को ये रट के आओ ये लिख के आओ नंबर मिल गए ये गो अवे विद द सिस्टम बिकॉज आपको शायद पता हो इसके लिए नथिंग स्किल इज कॉल्ड आउटकम आउटकम बेस्ड एजुकेशन सिस्टम वेयर यू आर एबल टू डिलीवर समथिंग आउट ऑफ योर एजुकेशन दैट बिकम योर स्किल आई थिंक विद दिस आई विल गिव द सेशन टू द मेंबर्स ओवर हियर एंड आई थिंक लेट्स हियर टू देम देन वी विल कंक्लूड दैट हाउ टू गो अबाउट But before that, one thing I would like to tell, that in the whole system, all those who are here, and even the policy makers, need to understand one thing, that it is very simple to teach how to drive a motorcycle on blackboard. If somebody is given a chance, if somebody is asked to teach on blackboard how to drive a motorcycle, he or she will take 2 minutes, they will make the clutch, accelerator and the wheel, and will say, press the clutch against the accelerator, it will run. But if they are given a chance to drive the motorcycle on the road, I am sure they will take 2 minutes even to understand where is the hole to plug the key. That is the basic difference, those who are in the field, those who are in the industry, and those who have been teaching on the blackboard. Please do not take it otherwise, because I also belong to a family where my father has been a teacher. But it is a fact of life that what we teach and what we do in the industry both are different. So there has to be a gap between the two. This is what was the basically topic which we have discussed just now. That what we are being taught, we are not being taught from practical perspective. And I think with this background, I think government of India and even government of Rajasthan also needs to change the recruitment rules for the post of vice chancellors and the professors also. For example, in AICT, they made it mandate that every teacher who are there in technical colleges, they have to go for minimum 1 month training in the industry. For 2 months training in the industry. Then only they will understand what is the requirement of the industry. Similarly, for the vice chancellor or the leaders of the education, I think we have to make a change in the system where we have to put them that they have to have experience in industry also. Because see, what we have been talking throughout the system, throughout the globe, that we have to make our education system for quality and basically it should be an outcome delivery based system. With these words, I hand over the session to you.
Thank you, sir. Very good afternoon to all. बहुत कम लोग बचे थे जितने सुबह थे जितनी सारी बातें हो रही थी आई कैन सी वेरी फ्यू पीपल हियर टुडे नाउ एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड द टॉपिक इज लार्जली अबाउट हायर एजुकेशन हम लोगों ने बातें करी और पिछला सेशन बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग था जिसमें सब लोगों ने बहुत सारी बातें ऐसी करी कि कितना गैप है और क्या पढ़ाना चाहिए. कमिंग फ्रॉम द एजुकेशन सेक्टर द बिगेस्ट गैप इज वी डू नॉट हैव गुड टीचर्स. सबसे ज़्यादा एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी फैकल्टी मेम्बर्स की आज भी है लेकिन हमारे पास कौन है पढ़ाने के लिए वो बहुत बड़ा सवाल है. क्योंकि जो हम स्किल सेक्टर की बात करते हैं हम करते हैं बच्चे क्लास में नहीं आते. बच्चे क्लास में क्यों नहीं आते? क्योंकि टीचर पढ़ाने लायक ही नहीं. और वहाँ पे वो लोग हम उन लोगों को एम्प्लॉय कर रहे हैं जो अपने फील्ड में अपनी क्लास में फेल हुए थे शायद और वो कुछ और नहीं कर पा रहे तो वो टीचिंग के लिए आ रहे हैं. इसलिए सबसे बड़ा गैप अगर हमारे पॉलिसी मेकर्स ने और हम लोगों में से जो एक्चुअली एजुकेशन सेक्टर में है इस चीज़ को समझ लिया और उस गैप को फिल किया कि हमें हाईली क्वालिफाइड टीचर्स चाहिए. द्रोणाचार्य की बात बहुत अच्छी कही सर ने लेकिन आज कितने गुरु हैं द्रोणाचार्य के लायक? आई एम अ फैकल्टी मेंबर मायसेल्फ एंड नाउ आई एम हेडिंग एन इंस्टीट्यूट एंड द डायरेक्टर ऑफ इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ क्राफ्ट्स एंड डिज़ाइन. मैं गर्व के साथ कह सकती हूँ हमारे यहाँ एक बच्चा ऐसा नहीं है जिसको एम्प्लॉयमेंट ना मिला हो. मिनिमम पैकेज जाता है 28,000 और 50,000 तक पैकेज जाता है बैचलर्स का. हम बच्चों को डिज़ाइन एजुकेशन देते हैं जैसे निफ्ट देता है NID देता है लेकिन उसके साथ हमारा फोकस क्या है? फोकस है क्राफ्ट. जो अभी बात कर रही थी अलका जी की बहुत सारे कारीगर ऐसे हैं जिनके बच्चे को क्राफ्ट फॉलो नहीं करना चाहते. हम वहीं पर आए हैं. हम उन कारीगरों के बच्चों को भी बुलाते हैं कि भाई आप आओ और पढ़ो और कारीगरों को बुलाते हैं पढ़ाने के लिए. इसलिए एज अ पर्सन आई एम कम्प्लीटली अगेंस्ट द रूल कि PhD होना चाहिए पढ़ाने वाले को. क्योंकि स्केचिंग करने वाला अगर PhD होगा तो वो स्केचिंग के बारे में लिख सकता है, स्केचिंग नहीं करा सकता. तो देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ इश्यूज. बहुत छोटी सी ये प्रॉब्लम है कि गैप है. गैप वो तब फिल होगा जब पढ़ाने वाले कायदे के होंगे और जब वो पढ़ाने आएंगे क्लास में तो बच्चे बिना अटेंडेंस के क्लास में हैं. आज मैं जब पढ़ाने के लिए जाती हूँ मुझे ये नहीं कहना पड़ता कि अटेंडेंस लो. मैं उनको बोलती हूँ सिर्फ जिनको मुझसे पढ़ना है वो आओ, अटेंडेंस सबको मिलेगी. जिसको नहीं पढ़ना वो बाहर चले जाओ, अभी निकल जाओ क्लास में. तो जिसको पढ़ना है वो खुद बैठेंगे, जिनको नहीं पढ़ना वो आप कितना अटेंडेंस लगा लीजिए वो इधर उधर करके चले जाएंगे. और उसके बाद आएगी इंडस्ट्री की प्रॉब्लम. और जो सबसे पहले सुबह नवीन जैन सर ने बात कही थी कि ये रही कुंजी या पास होने वाली किताब, इसको आप 4 दिन पढ़ लें. इसका मतलब आप यूथ को क्या सिखा रहे हैं? कुछ भी काम करने की जरूरत नहीं, मस्ती करो, सिर्फ 4 दिन पढ़ो. तो 4 दिन पढ़ने से, क्रैश कोर्स करने से आप क्रैश ही हो जाए. यू विल नॉट गो एनी वे. सो द होल कल्चर हैज टू चेंज. वी हैव टू बिकम मोर पॉजिटिव, वी हैव टू बिकम मोर इंटीग्रेटेड एंड वी हैव टू टीच आवर चिल्ड्रन टू बी इंटीग्रेटेड. इनफैक्ट खाली स्कूल्स की नहीं, हम डेली स्किल्स भी खोते जा रहे हैं. लुक एट सो मेनी यंगर गर्ल्स एंड बॉयज हु डोंट नो हाउ टू कुक, who don't know how to take care of themselves. So I think the entire society is on a downfall. So we have to begin, and we are doing a beginning. We are working very hard in the field. I would welcome everybody to IICD if you want to come. सबसे बड़ी चीज़ हमारी ये है कि हम जो professional degree वाले हैं वो तो पढ़ाते ही पढ़ाते हैं लेकिन जो कारीगर हैं master craftsman हैं उनको लगातार पढ़ाने के लिए बुलाते हैं तो gap bridge होता है. जो designer बनता है वो खाली table पर बैठ के sketch नहीं बनाता, उसको हथौड़ा चलाना भी आता है. अगर हम वुड की बात करें, स्टोन की बात करें, इनले वर्क आता है, टेक्सटाइल की बात करें तो खुद कपड़ा वीव करना आता है, एम्ब्रॉयडरी करनी आती है, सब कुछ आता है. 4 साल में वो डिज़ाइनर बनने को करता है. स्किल आती है, नॉलेज आती है और उन दोनों के साथ उसमें जो हिम्मत आती है वो बहुत आगे जाता है. और अगर 100 बच्चे निकलते हैं पढ़ करके उसमें से कम 25 बच्चे एंटरप्रेन्योर बनते हैं जो और लोगों को नौकरी देते हैं. सो आई थिंक दिस इज हाउ यू नो द फोकस शुड बी टू Of course, to bridge the gap, but to bring faculty members, जैसे कि सर ने बोला कि खुद इंडस्ट्री में जब वो ट्रेनिंग करके आएंगे तब वो बता पाएंगे कि उनको करना क्या. सो आई थिंक देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ इशूज बट या वी रियली नीड टू फोकस ऑन हायर एजुकेशन एंड इवन बिफोर हायर एजुकेशन. वी डोंट वॉन्ट एवरीबडी टू अननेसेसरी बी अनएम्प्लॉयड एंड जस्ट फिनिश स्कूल. सो विद दैट आई पास ऑन द माइक बिकॉज वी हैव लिमिटेड टाइम. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू. Thank you organizers for inviting me to share some of my views in this forum. थोड़ा सा मेरे लिए ये एक नया ग्रुप है क्योंकि ज़्यादातर मेरा काम जो रहा है वो बच्चों के साथ काम करने का रहा है, रूरल बैकड्रॉप में काम करने का रहा है, क्योंकि मैं एक सोशल साइंस रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट को रिप्रेजेंट कर रही हूँ यहाँ पर, और हम ज़्यादातर जो हमारा रिसर्च रहा है वो मेरा जो काम रहा है वो महिलाओं पर बच्चों के साथ। तो क्योंकि पहले सेशन में ये बात निकल कर आई और अभी तुलिका जी ने भी कहा कि गैप्स, अगर मैं ये देखूँ कि मेरे कुछ पिछले जो हमने काम किया है और स्पेशली इस पर जेंडर डायमेंशन और मैं लगाती हूँ इस पूरे स्किलिंग वाले पूरे सेक्टर की हम बात करें, तो जैसा कि इस रूम में भी दिख रहा है महिलाओं की रिप्रेजेंटेशन कम है और ज़्यादा पुरुष, विच इज आई गेस इन मोस्ट केसेस दिस इज व्हाट इज हैपनिंग। पर अगर मैं एक रूरल लड़की के परिप्रेक्ष्य से सोचूं कि व्हाट इज माय एस्पिरेशन, क्योंकि अगर आप किसी भी गवर्नमेंट स्कूलों में जाते हैं, अगर आप रूरल एरियाज में जाएंगे, अगर सरकारी स्कूलों में जाते हैं और बच्चों से बात करते हैं, लड़कों से भी और लड़कियों से भी, ज़्यादातर अगर आप लड़कियों से बात करेंगे तो जैसे पहले सेशन में किसी ने कहा कि थिंग्स हैवन चेंज्ड, वो डॉक्टर इंजीनियर या टीचर, अपने टीचर की बात नहीं, बट टीचर इज़ एन एस्पिरेशन, बिकमिंग अ टीचर इज़ एन एस्पिरेशन, और वो भी सरकारी टीचर बनना और भी ज़्यादा एस्पिरेशन। एंड दिस इज़, आप कहीं भी चले जाएंगे आपको ये दिखेगा कि जितना एक्सपोजर है, और कोई बैंकर कह देगा आपको, शायद कोई पुलिस में जाना है कह देगा, या लड़के हैं तो आर्मी की बात करते हैं, पर उससे ज़्यादा जिस तरह का एक्सपोजर की हम बात कर रहे हैं और जिस लेवल पे यहाँ पे हम हमारा डिस्कोर्स चल रहा है, और जो डिस्कोर्स एक रूरल कॉन्टेक्स्ट में शायद चल रहा है, उसमें बहुत मिसमैच, वो बहुत बात। और मैं ये भी जानती हूँ कि कई सरकारी प्रोग्रामों के तहत कुछ स्किलिंग की बात कही जाती है, लड़कियों के जो कस्तूरबा गांधी विद्यालय चलते हैं उसमें दो कोर्सेज चलते हैं, एक तो है ब्यूटिशियन का और एक है टेलरिंग, स्टिचिंग और टेलरिंग। पर एक सवाल इसमें ये है कि वो बच्चियाँ वो वहाँ पर वो कोर्स कर लें, वापस जाएंगी अपने गाँव में, तो उसकी सार्थकता कितनी है, when it still continues to be a very low end something, कि आप हर वो लड़कियाँ हर जगह तो जाके आप ब्यूटिशियन का कुछ कर सकती हैं, कपड़े सिलना क्योंकि एक जेंडर नॉर्म भी है कि लड़कियों को कपड़े सिलना आना चाहिए, तो शायद वो उसको थोड़ा बहुत वो आगे बढ़ा सकती हैं, पर इन टर्म्स ऑफ अदर स्किल सेट्स मुझे लगता है कि आर स्टिल way of in actually addressing the kinds of issues maybe a young girl in a rural context, वो क्या चाहती है, कभी हमने किसी ने पूछा है या नहीं, मुझे नहीं लगता, मतलब उस लेवल तक हम जा रहे हैं। और इससे पहले सेशन में भी किसी ने कहा कि अगर हम ब्लॉक स्तर पर, अभी मेरा एक थोड़ा सा रिसर्च था, आई एम लुकिंग एट एजुकेशन वर्क एंड मैरिज, तो बहुत सारी ऐसी महिलाएँ, यंग महिलाएँ थी जिनकी पिछले 10 साल में शादी हुई थी, गांव में रहती हैं, बच्चे संभालती हैं, वो ऑब्वियस है, पर थोड़ी बहुत जिनकी फार्मिंग है, फार्म पे काम करती हैं, बट देर आर नो अदर एवेन्यूज। अगर आप ये कहो अरे आप कुछ क्यों नहीं करते हो, तो उनको कहाँ जाना है, क्या करना है, कैसे करना है, कोई एवेन्यूज है ही नहीं। तो मुझे लगता है कि अभी भी हम बहुत सारे बच्चों जो जुड़ चुके हैं अलग अलग स्तरों पर, वो एक बात है, पर मुझे लगता है कि जिस तरह से हम लड़कियों को आगे ला सकते हैं, कैसे हम मोबिलाइज करते हैं, उसके साथ बहुत सारे अन्य इश्यूज आते हैं, कि अगर आप कोई ट्रेनिंग सेंटर में भी आप लड़कियों को ला रहे हो, तो आपको बहुत सारी अन्य चीज़ों को भी वहाँ पर देखना पड़ेगा, है ना, क्योंकि इतना आसान नहीं है कि गाँव से एक लड़की निकले और वो किसी सेंटर में आके ट्रेनिंग करें। तो मुझे लगता है कि जो लार्जर इसका बैकड्रॉप है और इश्यूज हैं, उसको भी हम देखें और उसके तहत किस तरह की स्किल लोग चाहते हैं शायद उस पर भी कुछ एक तो ये इस तरफ का डिमांड है कि भाई डिमांड कहाँ से और हम सप्लाई क्या करें एक तो वो बट ऑल्सो वॉट आर वी गिविंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ स्किल्स. मैं यहाँ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ राजस्थान से लोग हमारे यहाँ कभी रिसर्च असिस्टेंट की पोस्ट के लिए लोग आते हैं दे डोंट हैव एनी दे कैन नॉट राइट दे कैन नॉट आर्टिकुलेट दे कैन नॉट से कि मैं उनको गाँव में भेजूँ और बोलूँ ये सर्वे करके ला. ये बहुत एक व्यापक समस्या है. तो मुझे लगता है कि ये कुछ सारे जब हम बिंदुओं को हमको देखना ही पड़ेगा. हम अन्य चीज़ें बोल सकते हैं और कर भी सकते हैं शायद और बहुत अच्छा है कि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बच्चे निकल कर आएँ और यू नो कहीं ना कहीं स्किल्स के जो पूरा फ्रेमवर्क है उसमें अपनी बात को वो अपने मतलब क्योंकि एक हमें कहीं ना कहीं ये तोड़ना ज़रूर है. ये आइडिया सब चाहते हैं कि उनको एक सरकारी नौकरी मिले. आप देख लें गाँव में आप जाएँ पूछें तो ये एस्पिरेशन है कि मुझे एक सरकारी नौकरी पर आप और हम जानते हैं कि सरकारी नौकरियां मिलना इतना आसान नहीं. तो अगर सरकारी नौकरी नहीं मिलती है तो क्या है वॉट इज़ दी अल्टरनेटिव एंड वॉट इज़ द बास्केट ऑफ चॉइसिस दैट आई हैव इन फ्रंट. नहीं तो सब कंपटीशन की तैयारी कितने बच्चे करते हैं वो आप और हम जानते हैं. तो ये मेरे थोड़े थॉट्स थे मुझे लगा कि इस ग्रुप में मैं शेयर करूँ. आई थिंक इसको हमें थोड़ा सा एक लार्जर कॉन्टेक्स्ट में देखने की जरूरत है. धन्यवाद.
गुड आफ्टरनून मायसेल्फ के एल जोशी फ्रॉम जेके इंस्टीट्यूट टेक्नोलॉजी नंबर. बेसिकली मैं टेक्निकल इंस्टीट्यूट से बिलोंग करता हूँ लेकिन जहाँ स्कूल की बात होती है स्कूल में बच्चों को हम एक ही टारगेट देते हैं कि बच्चे अच्छे नंबर लें. अगर कोई बच्चा पढ़ने में कमज़ोर है तो वही उसका मॉरल डाउन हो जाता है कि आगे वो कुछ नहीं कर पाएगा नंबर कम आते हैं इसके. तो हमारा जो टारगेट है वो ये रहता है कि बच्चा ज़्यादा नंबर लें. ये नहीं होना चाहिए. उसका इंटरेस्ट डेवलपमेंट इंटरेस्ट देखना चाहिए. व्हाट इज़ हिज इंटरेस्ट उसका इंटरेस्ट किधर है ये हमें ज़्यादा देखना चाहिए ज़्यादा ध्यान दें कि कितने मार्क्स उसके आ रहे हैं. हमारा आज का एजुकेशन सिस्टम मार्क्स पर आधारित है. अगर कम मार्क्स आते हैं बच्चा वहीं डिमोटिवेट रहता है. सेकंड चीज़ है कि इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर या टीचर्स अच्छी क्वालिटी के नहीं हैं. तो ये भी एक बहुत बड़ी कमजोरी रहती है. जब अगर ऐसा नहीं होगा सुविधाएँ नहीं होगी तो बच्चे क्यों इंटरेस्ट लेंगे. इंटरेस्ट डेवलपमेंट सबसे बड़ी चीज़ है एजुकेशन सिस्टम.
Hello, good evening. I'm Hema Arjadani. I'm running Canvas International Group of the Schools. And, since I was part of the earlier panel, I was assisting it. Sab log baat karte hain ki hum log schools se shuruaat honi chahiye. Phir hum education higher mein aana chahiye. Then next aana chahiye. So I think mere hisaab se ye shuru early learning se ho jana chahiye jab hum 2 saal se bachche ko pehli baar school mein daalte hain. As sir says, there is a 3 stakeholder. I believe into there is a 4 stakeholders because parents are equally important in this role. Because जब हमारे पास स्कूल में बच्चे आते हैं पढ़ने के लिए और as earlier panel was saying कि इतना competition है कि बच्चे स्कूल जाते नहीं हैं 11, 12 करने के लिए क्लासेज भी कोचिंग्स के लिए चले जाते हैं. So where is the parent is you know are the parents are not responsible for that. Only education is responsible. We were just talking about okay, I'm running a college, so school is responsible. I'm running a school, I'm saying another. I think all are responsible. We have to jointly work together and ensure to you know because even if we are trying to change our education system, where we say yes, CBSE started this year's life skills, and we are trying to do different because rote learning is moving now, moving into the experiment learning. Still, when you talk about this. द पेरेंट इज कम इन टू द पिक्चर नहीं हमारे बच्चे को तो आया ही नहीं लिखना यू नो प्रेशर जो पीयर जो होता है मेरे पड़ोसी का बच्चा तो देखिए मैडम इतना कर लिया. सो समवेयर इन द यू नो व्हेन वी सिट इन सोसाइटी वी हैव टू सिट टुगेदर एंड देन वी हैव टू एनालाइज ईच एंड एवरी रोल ऑफ द पर्सन. एंड ऑफ द डे जब हम बात करते हैं मेरे बच्चे को डॉक्टर ही बनना है इंजीनियर व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द स्किल्स आज भी कितने मम्मी पापा रेडी हैं इस चीज को सुनने के लिए कि हाँ मेरा बच्चा यू नो बावर्ची बनेगा विच इज एंड दिस इज अ स्किल प्रोग्राम आई थिंक वन ऑफ द स्किल So when you say, okay, my ladka hai, usko kitchen mein kaam karna chahiye. No, he has to do the engineering first. You know, aspiration for the parent side is very high. And that comes into the role. And that pressure will start building up for the school, then next to next, and all are connected. So, you know, go back to this thing, and then when we talk about the international boards are there, when we talk about other countries, why they are doing, because the mindset is very clear. Anything my child is doing, it's good for them. That's important. My child should go. Humanity is important. I think nowadays humanity is one of the most, I can see the kids are actually opting to humanity. And then second thing is this, I know, like in race, chal raha hai, numbers ka. So number race, you know, hum ye nahi bol sakte ki number race sirf school walo ke liye. School walo ke liye bhi isliye hai kyunki parents bolte hain, aaj ki date mein every child is coming 99. Abhi 99 se upar kya hoga? When we saying ki job nahi hai, job mein jaake once you reach in a top level, nobody can become all CEO. One person is there as CEO, that's it. Rest all are different departments and people will work. So that has to be very categorically decided at the parents. So, you know, schools, colleges, these kind of workshops, we actually do together, work for the, you know, children and very clearly talk about this. Whenever I say, mera bachcha ye kar raha nahi, mera bachcha toh MBBS kar raha hai. And then I'm afraid about because my children is actually doing NIT or else any other, you know, something else. All are good. As far as my child should love that thing. That's the most important. So, as a school, we keep doing it. We are, you know, when we say experimental running in my classrooms, when we say creativity is happening in my classrooms, so, mere paas bhi parents aate hain aur ye daily hamare saath school mein parenting orientation, we set parent partnership programs in our schools and we keep doing it. And this challenge as a school is also going through that. It's not about the school is not wanted, but every, even a school, even a college, I understand why the, you know, it's not there. Yes, and teachers. As Nam said very clearly, ki agar koi option nahi mile, toh I think teacher ban jaiye. Yes, sir, yahi hota hai. If you go highly paid, you know, this is the only profession highly paid in world class cities and countries. I'm sure she's with me, right? So, I think we have to change our mindset first. As a person who runs the institute, very clearly decide what are our goal is and who all are the stakeholder is. And then very clearly you have to speak about the parents. Even the parents has come to you in the college for the admission, sit with them. I'm not sure about how nowadays is at the time of admission, are we doing counselling of the children, yes or no. But we need to talk about the parents as well because bachcha kuch aur cha raha hota hai, parent ka kuch aur hi, you know, mindset hota hai. To unse baat karna bahut zaruri hai kyunki usko kuch aur karna hai, lekin when, you know, pressure is too much, then everything will change. So that's on the my side as a school perspective. Thank you so much. Yeah.
With the education system, so as the faculty also gets interaction with the industry. Students also exposed to the relevance of the upcoming technology or various trades in different areas. And the faculty and the management both are understanding each other. And the students are getting the best benefit by revising the curriculum based upon the industrial requirement. What it will give, the point to understand, what it will give. Number one, the students are at par with the requirements of the industry. Curriculum structure is not allowed to be delayed for reframing. It is being reframed in real time as technology moves. And the students and faculty both are evolving the new technology, our new requirements, which is bridging the skilling gap, what people used to talk skilling gap. So skilling gap is only there when the market demand and actual supply is not in the same time domain, same platform, where the skilling gap will increase and further increase. So the first point is entire curriculum has to be based upon the industrial linkage, minimum requirement of the fundamentals, and presentation style, interaction style will only come once they interact with the utility professionals, industrial professionals, people visiting the places many times. This will give confidence not only to the students to understand how to face the problem, how to understand the problem, how to innovate for the problem, but also faculty gets also upgraded and industrial people also gets involved that they have to be an integral part of the education system. It is their also responsibility, because you keep in mind, whatever the academic institutions or professional institutions are delivering, they are delivering for the country and industries only. Ultimately, they are the beneficiaries. And therefore, without spending a single price, they are getting the benefit of all the manpower. So capacity building has to be supported by this industry as mandatory tax. I recommend to the government of India that whenever industries want to take the power, manpower of IIT or any diploma engineering institutions or ITI institutions, they have to pay the money for them. Why not? You are taking the manpower without any investment. And so the point is, once they understand they are investing the money, they will be very careful that the manpower should be at per their requirements and per their fitting requirements. So what I always plead, once we talk about the stakeholder concept is not in isolation. It is an integral component. And therefore, any education system, whether it is IIT education, diploma holders, engineering graduates, post graduates, doctoral students, or any professional students, they must have stake over entire involvement and accountability and responsibility automatically faced that whatever learning, they are learning at par with the requirements. And industries are fully aware that they are having thorough interaction and ultimately they are employable. I was around 15 years back, I was the country actually project leader of Arima TND, Department of Professor of IIT. I had a meeting with the country president, Arima TND, India Limited, that time Arima TND, now Snyder and Alstom. What I had proposed, the model I started and did one batch, that identifying the students in second year in the UG, that is engineering that you are talking about, same model can be taken for ITI and others also. Identifying the students at the second year level about their interest, which area they would like to go. And it is done at the departmental level by the faculty. And this is now introduced with the industry. And the industry will take up the students for training as internship in second year itself. And they will train them. And now at third year level, they are going further at the same industries of their choice. Fourth year level, they are going for the bigger projects. And finally, the industries are absorbing them because they have understood the candidate from second year to the fourth year. And therefore, for them, there is nothing can be interviewed because they are always in line with the students. So if they are interacting each time, they are assessing all the time. So if there are 10 students, they will absorb. And what best they are going to get? Students are getting the immediate job with a degree. Plus stipend they are getting second year, third year, fourth year, by the industry at the CSR fund. or as the investment from the industry, because they need the manpower at the end. And the finally, what industries gain? They gain the competent manpower, and there is no need of any training because the students have already been trained through them only since last 3 years. So what the point you would like to put the point? Academic institutions not are a default, it's system management which has to look into what should be the framework of education in the industry. It should be not in isolation that you visit once in a while, no. It is to be online, ongoing process. If it is done and showed the quality of the students is excellent, delivery is excellent, industrial output will be excellent, and all employment problems will be resolved. So we have to take from beginning itself rather than coming at the end and saying, talking about you skill now and then talk about the employment. With these words, I'm sure this model will work.
I think all the immediate speakers on the dais, I think they have shared their views and I think real experience, which I will just conclude in a few words. One of that is that we definitely, as we are talking about the quality of education, we need to definitely talk about the teachers, because they play a major role in the education system. If you go by any, I mean, quality school or a business school, maybe the 60-70% contribution goes to the teacher. Because with their experience, with their background, how much they are able to contribute to the student in terms of gaining the knowledge, acquiring the knowledge. Then definitely, second point well said, that the infrastructure of the institution. Because in the present scenario, as we have heard in the previous session, that we are teaching them, we are skilling them on an equipment which is not well versed with the equipment being used in the industry. So there is no point in going for skilling where you are teaching how to drive a cycle, and we are talking about motorcycle in the industry. So that gap has to be built in, which means the infrastructure in the college or school needs to be improved upon. Then that is the most important, which well said, that parents also play an important role in the whole education system. And in fact, as far as I remember, that we start since from the birth of the kid, we start saying, become engineer, become doctor, become this. And even we never say you become a teacher. And we never say you become a cook, you become a carpenter, because we feel that these are low profile jobs. But frankly speaking, I don't know how many of you have been to abroad. I think once you go abroad, all jobs are at par. There is no difference whether he's a carpenter or he's a bawarchi or he's a nai, whatever it is, barber. All are contemporary in the same place. That's the basic difference in the society. So I can say society also plays an important role. Aaj koi bhi ladki ka baap apni beti ki shaadi kisi carpenter se nahi karna chahega. Aap jitne yahan baithe hain, pucha jaye, sab mana kar denge. कुक से नहीं करना चाहेगा. ये हमें माइंडसेट चेंज करना पड़ेगा, ये कह के कि यार तुमसे शादी कर, जिससे कि यू कैन गेट द बेस्ट एंड द मोर ऑनेस्टेबल जॉब इन टर्म्स ऑफ देयर गोइंग टू ए जॉब वेयर यू मेक मनी आउट ऑफ अदर बिजनेसेस. दिस इज वन थिंग. देन बेसिकली इट इज ऑल्सो फैक्ट दैट वी हैव टू वर्क आउट दैट वी नीड टू कंसंट्रेट मेनली ऑन इंडस्ट्रियल टाइप्स रदर देन गोइंग फॉर ए But after a particular level, for going for a PhD, because I feel so personally that PhDs are so common available through internet nowadays. You can do anybody can do PhD, especially after coming up of the private universities, it has become a very common feature. If you see the trend, how many PhD holders were there in 2010 and how many are there in 2019, you'll find it is more than 100% high. So that needs to be controlled upon. I think definitely there should be a higher qualification, but that should be of quality. And definitely, well said that we need to keep on revising the course curriculum. I do appreciate that even in engineering college, as you did, the Fortran 4, the C language, which we learned in 1984, Kabul language, is still the same is being taught. So I think once we are talking about artificial intelligence, machine language, robotics, data analytics, we have to change the course curriculum. And even we have to work out a system where besides English, Hindi, we need to train them on other foreign language also, because that's a demand of time. Similarly, it was also conveyed that very good idea, I think this I also conveyed to my honorable minister, that apprenticeship in the schools and colleges need to be enhanced by deploying the students for training in industry. But what happens is once they go for training in the industry, we are being given the certificate just to fulfill the formalities. I think we need to work out a system where they are linked with the CSR, they are linked with the subsidy being given by the Government of India or by the state governments. Not only this, even they must be charged for that, because definitely none of the industry can run without manpower. We are paying money for power, we are paying money for electricity, we are paying money for water, we are paying money for sanitation. Then why we can't pay money for human resource capital? So I think we have to work out on that system also. And definitely, why the topic was discussed today, that is very important to understand. Just I wanted to brief to all those who are here that the business processes are changing. There is automation going on. This is one of the reasons. Then Agile will become a norm rather than expedited. Now nobody can, because we don't have a patience as of date. So now basically quick decision, quick activity, quick action is important rather than an expectation. Then blockchain is going to make a revolution in the process decision making and the way industry are being run. Similarly, business process will be dominated by collaborative work. आज आप देखिए एक इंडस्ट्री हाउस मल्टीपल जॉब्स करता है और मल्टीपल इंडस्ट्री हाउस सेम जॉब करते हैं. सो देयर इज अ रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ कोलैबोरेशन अमंग द सिस्टम. सिमिलरली देयर इज अबंडेंट डेटा, स्पेशली आफ्टर द इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स एंड आफ्टर द इंटरनेट व्हिच हैज कम आउट, अबंडेंट डेटा इन द ग्लोब, ऑन द इंटरनेट ग्लोब. आई थिंक वी हैव टू वर्क आउट अ मैकेनिज्म टू रीप बेस्ट आउट ऑफ दैट एंड टेक अ डिसीजन मेकिंग एंड दैट इज टू बी यूज्ड फॉर द इंडस्ट्री. सिमिलरली देयर इज अ there is an intersection between the cross border, which means basically there will be a cross border activities going on within the industry. So we need to generate cultural sensitivity. Even when we are talking about the interstate, inter-country, then I think within the inter-industry also we have to develop a cultural sensitivity to take care of others and how to basically respect other religion, other activities, other culture and all. Then impact of business, now it is going to change. Till now we have been talking about top of line. When I am saying top of line in the business, those who are from the commerce background, they understand top of line means how much is the revenue, how much is the profit. Now that concept is going. Now we have to talk on bottom of line in the business, which means the profit, the people and the society. That's the concept which is coming up. And I think with this I feel that a good education system, whether it is a prep school, whether it is a primary school, it is a high secondary school or a college, needs to ensure that it is able to basically enhance the capability of the learner. It is basically leading to a economical productivity. It is basically to develop a sustainable livelihood. It is basically there to contribute to peaceful and democratic society. And the last, that enhance individual well-being. I think with these words, I am thankful to the distinguished members over here and to all the speakers who have shared their experience. Thank you very much.